Oyster shells are being used to bring life back to the Indian River Lagoon. WPTV News Channel 5's Chris Gilmore met with St. Lucie County researchers and volunteers to learn how the oyster beds are helping to protect paradise.
At 353 square miles, there's plenty to see on the Indian River Lagoon. Environmental volunteer Krista Stone agrees.
I come here 3 to 4 times a week, and it is absolutely spectacular.
In St. Lucie County, almost 1,000 square feet of oyster beds make up the Indian Hill Stormwater Treatment Area, Oyster Reef. It's an effort to preserve and restore life in the area.
A lot of the fish that live on our artificial reefs as adults grew up here in the Indian River Lagoon. So they have to have habitat in order to grow up to a size where they can immigrate out to the ocean.
Coastal Resources Coordinator James Oppenborn and Stone say they're already seeing progress.
This oyster reef, after just a little bit over a year, has grown a lot of fairly mature oysters.
Part of the success of the project is the concentration of brackish water thanks to the stormwater outfall just a few feet away. The oysters are doing more than filtering water.
We're hoping it stabilizes sand and the sand does not move anymore, and it will provide a decent habitat or substrate for the seagrasses to take root.
Oppenborn says he was able to pay for the project with grant funding, but the oyster bags were put together and deployed by an army of volunteers.
People really get it, and they're very concerned about the environment and the health of our Indian River Lagoon. That's why I have, probably close to 300 oyster reef volunteers.
According to Oppenborn and Stone, living in an area where people care about the environment makes a huge difference in protecting paradise.
Based on your choice alone, you can create a difference, whether that's passing on kindness or volunteering with a local organization. There's always a way to make the world a brighter place.
Reporting in Fort Pierce, Chris Gilmore, WPTV News Channel 5.